Hey, this is Eric Hunter here, and in this video, I want to talk about pendulum energy because I get a lot of questions about this. And not everyone has taken my course in pendulum alchemy or in the universal pendulum, or not everyone has taken my pendulum healing certification program, three courses where I covered this topic extensively. So I just want to briefly explain it in a simplistic way. All right, so if you read my book on pendulum healing commands, I'll often make a command like send blue-green energy with your pendulum or send gray energy with your pendulum. So sometimes I'll say to send a type of energy with your pendulum. Now, the other thing you'll notice is that, like with a pendulum like this Asclepius pendulum here, if you go on my website, it will say this has white energy quality. And so each type of pendulum is believed to reflect a different kind of light. So people get confused. They're like, well, if I have a pendulum that's reflecting white light, can I send blue-green energy with it? Or if I have a pendulum that's reflecting white light, do I have to say send white light? Or when I say send white light, am I actually sending white light? Or if I say send blue-green, am I actually sending blue-green? So I want to explain that in this video. So what you need to understand is that there are two things going on. Number one, the pendulum itself is reflecting light from the environment. So there you can see right now, we wouldn't see it if it wasn't reflecting light. It would be invisible. The only reason you see something is because it reflects light and it has some color, and you can even see the light shining off of it. But on another level, the shape of the pendulum is believed to influence light in the environment, almost like a prism. So when you shine light, white light at a prism, it breaks the light up into its rainbow colors. And you've seen pictures of that, or maybe even done it as an experiment. It's a pretty well-known phenomenon. So white light contains all the different colors of the rainbow, is what we see as white. So when you have a pendulum, it is interacting with light from the environment. This can be biophotons coming from your hand, ambient light. It could be sunlight, moonlight, light from the lamps. There's always light. Whenever you are holding a pendulum, there is going to be at some level light coming towards the pendulum. A pendulum, when you hold it, there's no way for a pendulum to ever be in complete darkness. So there will always be light present, even if it's just biophotons coming out of your hand. So there's going to be light. And it's believed that the pendulum is interacting with this light. And based on the shape of the pendulum and the materials it's made out of, each pendulum interacts with this light in the environment in a different way. So, like this pendulum here, it has what's known as white light property, which means that passively it's just sending out, it's just constantly reflecting light. So here's a flashlight, right? So you could just imagine that this pendulum is just constantly emitting light, just like this flashlight does. It's just constantly sending out light. Now, there are other types of pendulums that make what's called gray energy quality. And what that in the past, this was mistakenly called negative green, by the way. There's no such thing as negative green with pendulums. Anyway, so what that means is that instead of it just being a continuous white light, the light is flickering like this. So as the pendulum moves, it's interrupting the light that's hitting it, and it goes light and dark, just like this flashlight right now is flickering. That's what a gray energy pendulum, or formerly known as negative green energy pendulum, does. And this is an interruption pattern, and it stimulates things to either end or be interrupted so that new change can occur. But it's not dangerous at all. It's just like having a flickering flashlight. Now, a white pendulum, though, is just continuous. Now, there are other types of pendulums that have different types of energy as well. So they have different types of light. Like some pendulums I sell have blue-green, And what this basically means is that the pendulum is passively reflecting light that hits it as it interacts with this light from the environment. So it's a completely passive process. All right, now here is the next level. You can also say a command where you say for the pendulum to send light. So I could take this pendulum and say, send blue-green energy to everyone watching this video. All right, so when I say a command like that, I am not actually sending any light at all. What I'm doing instead is I am invoking the archetype that that light represents. And with that invocation, I am sending the energetic qualities that come with it. And this is why I call the practice that I do pendulum alchemy. Because in the Emerald Tablet, one of the most famous alchemical texts, it says, as above, so below, everything is doing the operation of one thing. And at the end of the Emerald Tablet, they tell you what that one thing is. It's the operation of the sun. So it is the movement of the sun in the sky, the apparent movement of the sun from our position on Earth. It's obviously we're the ones moving, but it's apparent. So this rising of the sun, the apex of the sun at midday, the setting of the sun, and then the apparent disappearance of the sun is what alchemy is based on. And you can correspond energy to this cycle. You can also correspond many other things as well. So let me just show you a diagram of this. And I explain this extensively in my more recent courses, but just for example, if the sun is rising here at 6 o'clock in the morning on the left side, and then it goes up to midday, and then it goes here to 6 o'clock at night, and the sun starts to set, you have the twilight period, and then it goes into the nighttime at 12 o'clock midnight, you have the end of the day, the start of the new day, and then it goes back again to the dawn, and then it rises. So you can correlate the movement of the sun with the colors of the rainbow and electromagnetic energy. Basically, the visible spectrum of light corresponds to daytime. The dawn and the dusk periods correspond to those parts of the electromagnetic spectrum which are barely visible, like far red or, you know, ultraviolet. But then the nighttime corresponds to the types of energy which are invisible. So things like gamma rays, radio waves, things like that. You can also correspond energy to the stages of the human life. The sun rising is corresponded to the earliest stages of human development. Birth is the sun at midday. The sun is born after gestating in the sky all morning. Then the daytime is childhood of the sun. And then the evening is the senescence that leads to the death of the sun at midnight. And then this leads to the afterlife of the sun. And interestingly, in Western cultures, this period from 12 o'clock at night till around 4 in the morning when the sun starts to rise are known as the witching hours, because these are the times when spirits are most active. And this is the period that corresponds to the spiritual life of the sun or the death of the sun, the afterlife of the sun. And as you can see, you can correlate this with many things, the cycles of the moon, the human chakra system. There are many, many things that this correlates to. So when you say a command, you are not literally sending the energy with your pendulum. So when I say send blue-green, which would correspond to 3 o'clock in the afternoon, this is the time of the day that the sun is the warmest. This corresponds to the throat chakra. It corresponds to childhood, to ideal health, wellness. So when you do this with your pendulum and you say send blue-green energy, you are not literally sending the energy. You are invoking the archetypal qualities of that energy. You're invoking the quality of the mid-afternoon, of the waning moon, of the throat chakra, of childhood, of, you know, all the different things that it corresponds to, rejuvenation, ideal health. And this is where pendulum work becomes magic, because in magic, you invoke archetypes all the time and you invoke these for the magical power that you can get from it. So that's what we're doing when you say a command. You're not literally sending the energy. So To sort of summarize this, there are two ways to send energy with the pendulum. And the first way is just to passively allow the pendulum to interact with light that's present in the environment. The second way is to use a command to send, to invoke the archetype or all the qualities that that energy represents. And with that command, you can send those archetypal qualities of the energy to the person or the situation that requires healing, and they can respond to that stimulus. So when you hold a healing pendulum over someone and you don't say a command, the cells in the body and the body itself are passively responding to the stimulus from the pendulum. So is your aura and chakras, and those are based in light. So you're passively stimulating them, and it automatically will correct imbalances passively through stimulation. When you use a command, you're using your words and the movement of the pendulum to send a signal that invokes or carries all of the archetypal forces of that type of energy, and that can stimulate a healing response or change. So that is where pendulum work becomes alchemy. It becomes more like magic. Whereas when you're just passively doing it, it's somewhat more scientific because it's just based on the physical world. When you bring in the commands with the energy, you're invoking the metaphysical world. So, but either way, it will work to get results. So hopefully that makes this clear. There are two different ways that the pendulum is working. One is passively with light from the environment. The other way is through your commands, where you're invoking the archetype of that energy and sending it. So like I said, if you really want to understand the energy of pendulum and you want to get these detailed charts, take my course on the universal pendulum. I explain what every energy means. I show you exactly what it's related to, all the different archetypes. I explain how to use that type of energy and healing. Even if you don't have one of these universal pendulums, you can still use a regular pendulum like this Asclepius, for example, and you can use it to send the archetype of that type of energy. And you can send energy in different sequences in order to get results with a healing. Now, if you have a pendulum like universal pendulum, you can just use this pendulum and set it to the type of energy that you want. Or, you know, if you have different types of pendulums available to you, you can use these different pendulums to get different results. So each type of pendulum will have a different energetic quality. And if you know what the energy is, you can send a specific type of energy that way. So the universal pendulum course is perfect for that. Also, the pendulum healing certification program, I teach you how to both send energies using the pendulum, what the energies mean, and also how to do it passively using different pendulums. So both great resources for that. You can also get some idea about this from my books, but if you don't want to go down that road, all you basically need to know is that for healing and rejuvenation, you just can send blue-green energy. And if you want something to stop, or if you want to interrupt something in a way which is not harmful, you send gray energy. And as I said previously, gray energy was mistakenly called negative green in the past. But there is no such thing as negative green with pendulums. That's a complete myth based on massive amounts of misunderstanding. So anyway, I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching it. Post your questions and comments below. Bye.